and welcome back to this channel. My name is Sarah, and welcome to this second video in this series on how I made my wedding dress. In the first video, I talked all about how I figured out exactly what I wanted to make and then how I went about getting help designing the dress and the pattern with Camille Saint-Léger, and I will link that video here if you haven't seen it or if that interests you. In this second episode, I wanted to talk about fabric because figuring out what kind of fabric I wanted to use to make my wedding dress was hard. Not only because I had very little knowledge of wedding dress fabrics going into this project, but also because there was such a wide range of fabrics for all budgets and all kinds of effects that you want to achieve with your dress. And so I had to learn very quickly, and I figured this would be very helpful to share with you what fabrics in the end I picked and where, and about how much I spent on this dress total. So where I left off in the last video, I had just validated the last mock-up with Camille, who was going to then finish designing the pattern and deliver it to me with the instructions a few weeks later, and that was mid-December. And so even before that, probably around September, I started looking at the different kinds of fabrics that I could purchase, and Camille gave me a general idea of what kind of fabrics I need. So the kind of tulle that I would need, or the kind of lining fabrics that I could use, which was typically cotton or a silk pongee. And so I started ordering sample fabrics, and this is something that I couldn't do very much of just because it's actually really expensive to order samples of wedding fabric. Typically the sample costs about 10% of what the fabric costs per meter, and so for really nice fabrics, that could go up to 10 to 15 euros for a little swatch, or the kinds of fabrics I was looking at, it was more between 20 to 50 euros per meter, and so they were 2 to 5 euros per swatch, plus shipping. I think I spent in total about 25 to 30 euros on fabric swatches, and let me show you some of them now. Tulle comes in all different sorts of types, so weight, elasticity, color, weave, and it also comes in a wide range of prices. And so I did order a few samples of cheaper tulle. So tulle, you can find tulle at 3 to 5 euros per meter, up to hundreds of euros per meter, depending on if it's embroidered or if there are little things added to it. So I first ordered, for example, this little swatch. It was 3 euros a meter of this tulle, and you can see it's an optical white, just like the paper. And it has sort of an open weave. I'm not sure if you can see that. And it's quite stiff, kind of scratchy. And so I was able to show this sample and a few other samples to Kemi, and she definitely recommended something a little bit lighter and a tighter weave than this one, just because the way it hangs just isn't very elegant, and it'd probably be a little bit more costumey than elegant. And then I ordered a few swatches from Minerva, because sometimes I work with Minerva, and I know that they have a wide range of wedding fabrics as well. But a lot of their tulles, which come in very large swatches like this, are actually also quite wide weaves like this, or very elastic. And I discovered that I didn't really want an elastic tulle. I wanted something, because elasticity creates a little bit more of a bottom weight and hang, and I wanted something that floated a little bit more. And in the end, all of these had sort of a very open weave, a little bit more fishnet-like. And so I didn't find anything there that I particularly wanted to work with, which left for online shopping the more expensive fabrics, of course. And I found two in particular that I thought I'd want to work with. And the first is Le Tissu de Catherine, which is a fabric shop in France specializing in wedding dress fabrics. So in that shop, I got these swatches. They're very, very small, but they're pretty effective. And this one had this illusion tulle, is what it's called. It's very smooth, the weave is much smaller, and it just feels really soft. And they had it in white and off-white, which is a little bit whiter than what I was going for, but still a good option. And this was about 48 euros per meter. And then two swatches that I ordered after Kemi specifically recommended these fabrics is this one. This is a very, very light tulle from Stragier. So it comes in these cardboard sort of swatches here, and you can see this one was 49.50 a meter. And oh, this is just lovely and very, very floaty. And then for the bodice piece, we were also thinking of using this pleated tulle, which is pretty cool. It's 100% polyester, and because it's already micro pleated, it would hold a certain pleat across the bust. So that was also a possibility. So then after keeping these in mind and knowing that I was looking for a cotton or silk blend for the lining, I was able to go fabric shopping in person, in shops. And so I will let my past self take it away with a video that I took right before going fabric shopping in Paris. Hi everybody. So today is January 21st and it is a gloomy, cloudy morning and I am being quiet because my fiance is still sleeping. But today I am planning on going fabric shopping for my wedding dress. And first I'm heading to a ballet class. I try and get to my ballet class when I can on Saturday mornings, especially because it helps me move my body and move to music and kind of evacuate all of the stress, but I'm a little bit worried because I haven't been going regularly with all of the wedding appointments, but I think it'll be fine. But yeah, anyway, after my ballet class, I am going to go look for fabrics. I'm excited to talk about it with fabric professionals in person to see what they recommend for the different layers, especially for the lining. Maybe I can save a little bit of money there instead of getting like a silk. And yeah, I'm excited to go and see the fabric in person. I'll be going to the traditional fabric shops in the north of Paris by the Sacré-Cœur, and going especially to the wedding counters, which I have always walked past but never stopped at. And I'm excited to see what they have, to see what they recommend, and to touch the fabrics especially. And so I'll be keeping in mind what colors I want. So you'd be surprised, there are a lot of colors of white. And it ranges from off-white to porcelain to optical white. And so I'm aiming for more of an off-white porcelain color because I think that white is a little bit too harsh on me. I'm excited to see these fabrics and I hope they fit in my budget. I think that's one of the hardest parts of this project, is starting out and not knowing exactly how much fabric I'll need and exactly how much I'll be spending. But I think that it will go well. And yeah, I'm really excited. Once in the neighborhood of the Sacré-Cœur, I first headed to Tissus de Rennes, which is a fabric shop with lots of different fabrics, but also a wedding counter. And there I got a lot of advice from a very helpful shop assistant. First, I looked at a pongee de soie, or a silk pongee, for the lining. And then I looked at their tools, and of the drape and color that I wanted, which was more of an off-white porcelain color, they didn't have very many to choose one. They only had two, and one was very stiff, but one was a little bit more beige than I wanted, but very interesting. I also tried other shops as well, including the Marché de Saint-Pierre shop, but I didn't find anything that was any different from, or less expensive, or better than what I had already seen at the Tissus de Rennes shop. In the end, I ended up visiting very few shops in the north of Paris because only a few of them had wedding-specific fabrics and help. And I definitely needed assistance in picking out these fabrics because I didn't know, or I'd never worked with these fabrics before, so I definitely wanted to know the composition of the fibers, the weave, and the weight, and a lot of times that's not indicated in stores versus online. And so I was pretty happy with just Tissus de Rennes and their wedding counter. I found different kinds of fabrics that I perhaps wanted to work with. So mid-January, Camille was able to deliver to me the mock-up of the bodice part of the pattern. So like this, and then she was also able to deliver the pattern pieces. So she had finished drafting the pattern and I got the pieces, and on the pieces, especially for the skirt, she indicated how much fabric I would need to cut out each piece, and then it was up to me to figure out how many layers of tulle I wanted, for example. But before purchasing the fabric, I wanted to wait until I had the instructions, just in case, because I wanted to make sure that I had everything and that I could just order all in one go and not need to order more meters of fabric and pay more delivery fees later. And she needed a little bit more time for that. And in the meantime, I was off to Taipei and Tokyo for work. And so I had 2 weeks to think of something absolutely different. And I ended up receiving the instructions while I was in Taipei at the end of January. And so by the time I got back beginning of February and ordered the fabrics, I wasn't able to receive the fabrics until mid-February, and then I was able to get going. So let me show you now the fabrics that I ended up ordering. This is, for example, a cotton and silk blend satin that I purchased for the lining piece. There were two kinds of lining, and this lining was between the lining that was touching my body and the tulle draping. And so it was see-through. So the draping was a little bit transparent, and this sort of pearlescent sheen of this satin fabric was showing through in the bodice, and I just love this fabric. This was 30 euros a meter, and it's 70 grams per meter, and I bought 1 meter of this because I figured even though I only needed probably a quarter of that, I'd have enough to cut it out multiple times and stuff. And it was difficult to work with, so I'm glad that I did that. And then this is how I also made these straps for the dress. And then for the lining that would be touching my body in both the bodice and the skirt pieces, I bought this cotton and silk blend voile, which is the most beautiful voile fabric I've ever touched or worked with in my life. It has a heavier hang than a 100% cotton voile, and this is also in the ivory color that they have at Stragier. Both of these fabrics were purchased at Stragier, and this is 23 euros a meter, and it is 40 grams per meter squared. And I purchased 6 meters of this one. I wanted something that was light and floaty and that would behave a bit like the tulle. This does hang heavier than the tulle in the skirt, which created certain logistical problems that I'll go over when I talk about the skirt. But oh my goodness, this was just the most luxurious fabric against my skin, and I'm really happy that I picked something with a little bit of silk in it for that luxury aspect. So now let me tell you all about the tulle that I chose for the skirt of this dress. Wedding fabrics, especially in the skirt pieces, you always want to look for 3 meter wide fabrics so that you can cut out the skirt without any seams down the middle. So you can cut out the entire length and just have seams at the side. Especially with tulle, because seams down the middle are very visible, or the seams in general are very visible. So you don't want seams in the center front and the center back. Unless that's your style. So with the 7 layers, I decided to have 2 layers of semi-stiff tulle in the bottom, 3 layers of medium stiff tulle in the middle, and then 2 layers of very light sort of tulle on the top. And so for the bottom layers, I chose this, it's called semi-flexible tulle from Stragier in their porcelain color. And, ooh. So this is probably the one that has the most volume and stiffness in the tulle that I worked with, and it was probably the hardest tulle to work with as well, because it stuck to everything and it was less flexible, a little bit less, I don't know, it was just harder to work with. But this was 20 euros a meter, and I bought 7 meters for the 2 layers of the skirt in the bottom. And then for the 3 middle layers of the skirt, I bought this tulle from Tissu de Rennes. So this tulle is definitely a little bit more off-white than the other tulles, if I can show you in comparison. So this is the layer that goes in the bottom, if you can see. And if you want to see the color of tulle, you bunch it up like this, and then you can sort of see the real color to it. So this is the bottom layer, and this is the one that I bought from Tissu de Rennes. And this tulle was perfect for this project. It was a little bit darker than I wanted, but it was the perfect sort of drape and weave. All of this is 100% polyester, but oh my goodness. And this was the saving grace, because this was only 890 a meter, or 890 euros a meter, and I had to buy 10 meters for 3 layers of the skirt. And this is also 300 centimeters wide, and ugh. I also made my veil out of this, but I will talk about that later. but yeah, this tulle definitely was a great find at Tissu de Rennes. And then for the top layer, the 2 top layers of the lightest tulle, I chose, this magnificent tulle from Stragier in this extra flexible and light tulle in the porcelain color. This is 17 grams per meter square, and it was 49.50 euros per meter. So I definitely splurged on this one, but this is the one that was going to be most visible. And this is also the layer that I used. I used the scraps to do the draping across the bodice. And so it was the most important. It was the most visible layer. And I definitely wanted it to float while I walked, and it did exactly that, and so I'm really happy with this tulle. And then for this one, I also needed 7 meters. So then I also bought a few notions that were wedding dress specific, such as this boning that would go in the bodice seams to hold the bodice up and help redistribute the weight of the skirt, and I bought more than I needed just in case. And then I also purchased these little like rubbery nubs to go in the ends of the boning so that the boning wouldn't poke through the very delicate fabric of the bodice and poke me. and then other things like an invisible zipper, or I also wanted to create a bustle in the back for dancing later in the night. And so I purchased these little buttons, and then a sort of like loop thing that I'll show you later, but I can't find now, but I'll show you on the dress. And then I also purchased a ribbon to hold up the train and also put it on my wrist if I wanted to, so things like that. And I think I spent about 25 euros in total on notions. So to give you an idea of what I spent in total on this dress, I spent about 800 euros on fabric, on the final fabrics that I actually used in the dress. And I say this because I made a few mistakes, which were horrible at the time, but that I'm coming to terms with now. I, for example, ordered 7 meters of the wrong tulle fabric, which cost me about 200 euros, or I had a few transparency issues with the bodice, which cost me 50 euros figuring out, like, playing with different fabrics. And so I think to err is human, and especially making this project for the first time, I should have allowed for a budget for mistakes because, anyway. So I would have spent about 800 euros on the fabric if I had made no mistakes, and in the end I spent about 1100 on the fabric. And then working with Kemi, so she was helping with me design the dress and then the pattern, and then she wrote out the instructions and she was available for all questions, which was incredibly helpful, especially for picking out the fabric. That was 695 euros working with her. And so in total, not counting the train rides, for example, from Paris to Lille to go meet with Kemi, or the other notions that I bought experimenting with making this dress, I spent about 1800 euros on this dress. It's difficult to say whether or not making your own wedding dress is worth it budget-wise. It depends on your budget, it depends on what you want, and I think that I know that this was definitely worth it for me, getting the kind of dress that I wanted exactly to my body and to my style. And I know that having someone else make it for me, for example Kemi, that would have cost me about 3500 euros, if not more, to have someone else sew this dress for me. If I had just bought one of the dresses that I saw in the shops, that would have cost probably around 1500 euros, which would have been a lot less, but wouldn't have been exactly my style or color or fit. And so I think it was worth it for me. It was a little bit more than I planned on spending, but it was well worth it. And in the end, I don't have any issues with how much I spent on it personally. And I'm forgiving myself for my mistakes. So once I got all of the fabrics about mid-February, I was able to start sewing, and that was about 12 weeks before my wedding, so I definitely needed to get into it fast and sew with all of my free time. And I did want to pre-wash some of the fabrics just because I did plan on getting the wedding dress washed after the wedding. Luckily, tulle does not need to be pre-washed or prepared in any way. It is 100% polyester and pretty easy to work with, actually, I discovered, but I will talk about that later. And so I only needed to pre-wash the lining fabrics, and since they were cotton and silk blends and the silk was only 20% of the composition, I figured I could wash it myself by hand without sending it to the dry cleaners, and it turned out fine. I created a fabric bath with some soap specifically designed for delicate fabrics, and I kind of just squished it into the fabric in the bath in tepid water and let it soak for a little while, and then used all of the square meterage of my house to dry it, especially the lining piece of 6 meters. That was pretty interesting, figuring out how to stretch it out and let it dry without touching anything. And then I was ready to get working on this dress. I hope that this video is helpful for you and that you enjoyed it. I have linked all of the fabrics that I could that are still available and online that I used in the description below, so don't hesitate to go check them out if you're looking for similar fabric. In the next episode, I will talk all about the construction of the bodice, so including inserting boning, working with delicate fabrics, dealing with transparency issues, and also draping the tulle, which was a fascinating process that I'm really excited to share with you. I hope that you are doing well, and I will see you again here soon. Bye-bye.